Please tell me you've got Jason a Christmas present.
Oh, no, we don't bother with all things like that. He'd probably go, what am I going to do with this? I've got to travel to God knows where next week.
Welcome to my festive extravaganza.
You singing all these Christmas songs
yes.
brought me so much joy.
That's all I want.
How special was it having all your family there to watch?
Incredible, incredible. And I'm just so glad that my voice didn't let me down, because you never know, singing completely live, it could have been an absolute train crash.
You sounded phenomenal.
Thank you.
As you always do.
Thank you.
We're obviously celebrating Christmas. I was wondering if you could buy Rebecca Welton any Christmas present, what would it be, aside from shortbread?
Me.
I certainly wouldn't buy a shortbread. What would it be? Oh, to buy Rebecca Welton something. She's kind of got everything materialistically. She doesn't need anything there. I think she would buy a house for Keeley Jones next door.
That's a good present. Please tell me you've got Jason a Christmas present.
Oh, no, we don't bother with all things like that. He'd probably go, what am I going to do with this? I've got to travel to God knows where next week.
Speaking of Jason, though, as a huge Gaga fan, a proud little monster, you and Jason singing Shallow was just everything to me.
Thanks. That was kind of a happy mistake, really. We were going to be singing something else, and then we decided it was in the wrong key for both of us. So 2 days before that, I just went, well, you've sung Shallow before. I've never sung it, but I like it. So why don't we just do that? That's literally how that came about.
Well, now that you've basically both been Gaga and Bradley Cooper, which other iconic duo would you like to take on?
I don't think we need to take on anyone else. I think he and I are perfectly happy. We might, you know, whack out a tune next year at Thundergong again, because we raised over $800,000 on the night.
That's incredible.
For an amazing charity, Steps of Faith, who basically give money to single and double amputees who don't have any healthcare, can't afford any healthcare. So to do that, I will be back there. Absolutely the first one. Getting my microphone out again. We're far from the
shallow now. One of my favourite things about Christmas is, of course, Christmas movies. Is there one that you watch every year without fail?
I mean, there's one that I watch even when it's not Christmas, and that's Love Actually. It's just all those individual, the scene work, the scene partners. I don't think there's a weak link in the whole thing. I think it becomes more and more iconic as time goes on, and it's such a simple message.
Is there a particular favourite scene of yours? For me, it's Emma Thompson when she cries.
100% when she goes. Gets herself together.
It gets me every time. Don't give yourself
away. Oh, we've all been there.
I feel like you would be the perfect Christmas host. Who would your three dream Christmas dinner party guests be? If you could have
like
anyone.
Dinner.
Yeah.
Ooh. Gosh, that's a hard one. Emma is pretty fabulous. She and I have worked together quite recently and we had an absolute love fest. I think she and I would probably get a bit hammered together. Maybe the lady on your top, Miss Streisand.
Barb, as I like to call
her. Yeah, absolutely. I would have loved to have sat down with, like, Dean Martin, somebody like that from that era, who would just be able to tell you what it was like back then, that heyday of big band, and, you know, I would really love that.
What is Christmas like in your house? Like,
quite
do you have
quiet.
Any traditions?
No, not really, just quite quiet and calm and, yeah.
That's nice.
Lovely and chilled and traditional. My parents are quite traditional.
Oh, I love that. I feel like you are one of the most universally loved people. You just bring people so much joy and happiness. I'm interested to know, what's one of the most amazing fan interactions you've had? One of the most memorable ones?
Juno Temple and I had quite an amazing moment once. We had a mother and daughter come up to us in the street and they both got quite emotional and they said that the scene work that Juno and I did together, the daughter had been watching the show and reached out to her mum by email, they hadn't spoken for years, and said, I want you to watch this and then I want you to contact me. And they got back in touch with each other because of the relationship between Rebecca and Keeley.
Wow. What a way to finish. On that note, thank you so much for talking to me.
Great to meet you.
The Christmas special is brilliant.
Thank
I just
you, lovely.
Loved it.
And
thank
keep
you.
Up your t-shirt game.
Thank you.